Welcome to a presentation on absolute extrema. The goals of this video will be to determine the absolute extrema on a closed and open interval. Let's take a look at a definition. F of C is an absolute minimum if F of C is less than or equal to F of X for all X in the interval. Remember that F of C is a Y value. So if this Y value is less than or equal to all other Y values on the interval, it's an absolute minimum. And F of C is an absolute maximum if f of c is greater than or equal to f of x for all x in the interval. If we're talking about y values, it may help to think of finding the max and mins by finding the highest and lowest point on the intervals. So for example, if we consider this function on this interval, this is the obvious high point, therefore this y value is going to be the absolute max. This is the obvious low point on the graph on this interval, therefore this y value is the absolute min. Now you may think this point over here might be an absolute minimum. It is a relative minimum because it is a low point. However, it's not the lowest point or the smallest y value on the given interval. Therefore, it's not an absolute minimum. Looking at this graph, this is the obvious high point again. Therefore, this y value would be the absolute max. The y value of this low point would represent the absolute minimum. What we should see here is that the absolute extrema can occur on the endpoints as well as at the critical numbers. We should be aware that some textbooks refer to maximums and minimums when they are talking about absolute max and mins. So we need to make sure that when we're talking about relative extrema versus absolute extrema, we distinguish between the two. If the interval is not closed or the function is not continuous, it takes a little more thought to determine absolute extrema. This point down here is an obvious low point, therefore the y value of that point would be the absolute min. However, we do not have an absolute maximum up here because we are looking at an open interval, therefore there is no absolute max. Similarly, over here we can see that this y value would represent the absolute max. However, down here what seems to be a low point at x equals 0 is a point of discontinuity. Therefore, there is no absolute minimum on this interval. Okay, let's look at some guidelines for finding absolute extrema. Step 1, we'll find the critical numbers. Step 2, we'll evaluate the function at those critical numbers. Then we'll evaluate the function at the endpoints of the closed interval. The least of these values is the minimum or absolute minimum, and the greatest is the maximum or absolute maximum. Let's go ahead and give it a try. So we have this function, we want to find the absolute extrema on the closed interval from 0 to 4. Let's find the critical numbers. Set this equal to 0 and solve by factoring. We have two critical numbers, so we need to find f of 0, f of 2, and also at the endpoints. We're already using 0, but we still have to find f of 4. We're going to evaluate the function at these three x values and then draw our conclusions. Let's go to our graphing calculator. I've already typed the function into y1. My table feature is set on ask, so if I hit second graph, I can just type in 0, 2, and 4. The corresponding y values would be 0, negative 4, and 16. So the largest value is our absolute max at x equals 4, and the smallest value is our absolute minimum on the x value of 2. So that's pretty straightforward. The largest value is our max, the smallest value is our min. Let's go ahead and verify it with a graph. Here's our absolute minimum at x equals 2. Here's our absolute max of 16 at x equals 4. Let's try another. Determine the absolute extrema on the closed interval from 1 to 5 of the given function. Let's find our critical numbers. You might want to rewrite this as x plus x to the power of negative 1. So our derivative function would be equal to 1 minus x to the power of negative 2. Now the derivative does not exist at x equals 0, since this is equal to 1 minus 1 over x squared, but 0 is not in the interval, and in fact it's not in the domain of the function. So we'll go ahead and set this equal to 0 and solve. We might decide to multiply both sides by x squared. That would give us 0 is equal to x squared minus 1, which is factorable. So we have two critical numbers, x equals negative 1 and x equals 1. Again, we have to be careful. Negative 1 is not in the interval we're considering, so we won't use negative 1. So we need to evaluate f of 1 from here. We've already used 1, so we'll also find f of 5. Again, we'll go back to our graphing calculator, type in our function, and go to the table. And we have 2 and 5.2. So here's our absolute max, here's our absolute min. Absolute max of 5.2 at x equals 5, and absolute minimum of 2 at x equals 1. And here's our graph to verify. Okay, let's try one more on an open interval. If we want to find the absolute extrema on an open interval, we need to be a little more careful. So again, we'll start by finding the critical numbers. Set this equal to 0 and factor. So we have three critical numbers, x equals 0, x equals negative 1, and x equals 1. Since the interval for this function is all reals, we obviously cannot test any endpoints. So what we're going to do is actually go back to the second derivative test, determine if we have relative extrema, and then from that determine if we have absolute extrema. So we're going to take these x values, sub them back into the original function here. I've already done that, and we found these three points. Now remember, the second derivative test will tell us whether the function is concave up or down at these points. So what we'll do now is find the sine of the second derivative at x equals negative 1, 0, and 1. I've already found our second derivative. Let's go ahead and do this mentally. If we sub in negative 1 for x, we'll have 12 minus 4, 8, which is positive, which means that this function will be concave up at that point. At x equals 0, we'd have negative 4, which is obviously less than 0, so it's negative, so it's concave down on this interval. And at x equals 1, again, we'd have 12 minus 4, 8, which is positive, so again, it's concave up. So what we can conclude from this is that we have a relative min at that point, a relative max at 0, 0, and again, a relative min at 1, negative 1. But the question is, are any of these absolute extrema? I'm a little weary of this point representing a relative maximum, because notice that the end behavior is going up to the left, and the end behavior is going up to the right as well. Let's take a quick look at the graph to determine our final answer. Here we can see that these two points are the lowest points of this function. Therefore, negative 1 would be an absolute minimum. However, this point here, where y is equal to 0, is not the highest point on the function. Therefore, it's not an absolute max. We do not have an absolute max because this function goes up forever to the left and to the right. So let's go back and record this information. We don't have a relative max, but we do have a relative minimum of negative 1 that occurs at x equals negative 1 and x equals 1. Again, here's our graph to verify. I hope that helps explain how you can find absolute extrema. Thank you for watching.